Mr. President, I would not rule out the chance to preserve a nucleus of human specimens. It would be quite easy. At the bottom of some of our deeper mine shafts, radioactivity would never penetrate a mine some thousands of feet deep. And in a matter of weeks, sufficient improvements in dwelling space could easily be provided.
How long would you have to stay down there?
Well, let's see now. Cobalt thorium G. Radioactive half-life of... I would think that possibly 100 years.
You mean people could actually stay down there for 100 years?
It would not be difficult, mein Führer. Nuclear reactors could... I'm sorry, Mr. President. Nuclear reactors could provide power almost indefinitely. Greenhouses could maintain plant life. Animals could be bred and slaughtered. Quick survey would have to be made of all the available mine sites in the country. But I would guess that a dwelling space for several hundred thousand of our people could easily be provided.
Well, I would hate to have to decide who stays up and who goes down.
Well, that would not be necessary, Mr. President. Could easily be accomplished with a computer. And the computer could be set and programmed to accept factors from youth, health, sexual fertility, intelligence, and a cross-section of necessary skills. Of course, it would be absolutely vital that our top government and military men be included to foster and impart the required principles of leadership and tradition. Actually, they would breed prodigiously, eh? There would be much time and little to do. But with the proper breeding techniques and a ratio of, say, 10 females to each male, I would guess that they could then work their way back to the present gross national product within, say, 20 years.
But look here, Doctor, wouldn't this nucleus of survivors be so grief-stricken and anguished that they'd, well, envy the dead and not want to go on living?
No, sir. Excuse me. Also, when they go down into the mine, everyone would still be alive. There would be no shocking memories. And the prevailing motion will be one of nostalgia for those left behind. Combined with a spirit of bold curiosity for the adventure ahead.
Doctor,
you mentioned the ratio of 10 women to each man. Wouldn't that necessitate the abandonment of the so-called monogamous sexual relationship? I mean, as far as men were concerned.
Regrettably, yes. But it is, you know, a sacrifice required for the future of the human race. I hasten to add that since each man will be required to do prodigious service along these lines, the women will have to be selected for their sexual characteristics, which will have to be of a highly stimulating nature.
I must confess, you have an astonishingly good idea there, Doctor.
Thank you, sir.
I think we ought to look at this from a military point of view. I mean, supposing the Ruskies stashed away some big bomb, see, and we didn't. When they come out in 100 years, they could take over.
I agree, Mr. President. In fact, they might even try an immediate sneak attack so they could take over our mineshaft space.
Yeah, I think it'd be extremely naive of us, Mr. President, to imagine that these new developments are going to cause any change in Soviet expansionist policy. I mean, we must be increasingly on the alert to prevent them from taking over other mine shaft space in order to breed more prodigiously than we do, thus knocking us out through superior numbers when we emerge. Mr. President, we must not allow a mine shaft gap.
Sir, I have a plan. Yeah!